So you probably clicked this video because you're interested in working as a nurse on an inpatient psychiatric unit. And if you're wondering what you actually do, you've come to the right video because in this video, I'm going to be going over 5 critical responsibilities of a psych nurse on an inpatient psychiatric unit. So stay tuned. Welcome back, Psych Dude family. It's good seeing each and every one of you guys today. If you are new to this channel, let me formally introduce myself. I'm the Psych Dude. I'm a board-certified psychiatric mental health nurse practitioner, and in this channel, I go over several different subjects to educate the public about mental health, ways to improve your lifestyle, topics related to nursing, nurse practitioners, and specifically psychiatric nurse practitioners like myself. If you are interested in any of these topics, feel free to subscribe. Make sure you give this video a big fat thumbs up, just to help with the algorithm and just spreading my knowledge and spreading my videos across the interweb. So if you feel like you want to spread this, definitely feel free to share this video. And then also make sure you follow me on Instagram at The Psych Dude. So you probably clicked this video because you're interested in finding out what exactly do psych nurses do on an inpatient psychiatric unit. And honestly, that is a great question and it's a great observation because there's not that many videos out there actually explaining what we do. And it's important for you guys to know, especially if you're trying to make a decision on whether you want to switch to psych or you want to make psych the actual unit that you start off your new nursing career on. And it's important that you actually find out and realize what we do on a daily basis. And this could apply to a lot of different people. It can apply to LPTs, it can apply to LVNs, RNs, PAs, NPs. As long as you're working on an inpatient psych unit, a lot of the things that you're going to be doing here is geared towards that. But I am going to add in a little bonus in terms of what actual psych nurses do so you guys know going forward. So without further ado, let's get started on the 5 critical responsibilities of a psych nurse. Let's go. So the very first critical responsibility of a psych nurse is, well, not in any particular order, is your ability to conduct the mental health assessment. So the mental health assessment is important because you have to be able to understand why they're there. This includes the history of present illness. So you want to see exactly what's going on in their life and you want to be able to portray a picture or paint a picture for the provider so they know exactly why the patient is actually there. You have to be able to ask the right questions and you have to be able to understand whether or not they're either suicidal, homicidal, hearing voices, seeing things, paranoid, or having some sort of delusion. And you have to be able to paint that picture for the provider and being able to see exactly what is going on. Another important part of it is being able to see what their past psychiatric history is, because it's important for you to be able to understand that because you want to see how high risk they are. Yes, there's a reason why they're there, but you want to see what their past history actually entails. And then also you want to be able to assess and ask the right questions to see what their family history is. And you just want to be able, in this whole mental health assessment, is to paint a picture for not only the provider, but you want to be able to do that for the other team members as well, because you want to understand what the whole thing is. And the reason why I say this is a critical responsibility is because if you kind of just ask the bare minimum questions and not necessarily give a good indication of why they're there, then you're not going to necessarily help other team members in helping them get the care that they need. So it's an important responsibility, and this is what you do a lot of the times, especially when you are working on a psychiatric inpatient unit. So the second critical responsibility of a psych nurse is being able to develop and follow through in the individualized care plan. And in this individualized care plan, you have to be able to understand what exactly is going on. When you develop it, you want to be able to see where they're actually progressing and how they're progressing through their care plan. So this involves therapy, this involves going to groups, this involves medication management, and you want to be able to help in that development and help follow through that development so patients get the highest quality of care possible. And the reason why I say this is extremely critical is because, like I said earlier, you want to be able to guide the patient along in order for them to get and receive the highest quality of care possible. And you being able to help develop and help follow through with this care plan, you're going to make sure that this care plan is geared towards them, just not in such a general way, but then geared towards that individual person for them to get the help that they need in order for them to get back to their daily life. So the third critical responsibility of a psych nurse is you have to be able to provide crisis intervention. Meaning, whenever there are moments where patients are being extremely aggressive, patients are being extremely psychotic, things like that, you want to be able to provide that intervention in order for them to maintain their safety and your safety and people around them, the safety of those people. And it's important. And the reason why I say this is extremely critical is because if you're not able to provide that crisis intervention, then there's going to be a lot of people around you or even yourself, you're going to get hurt. And you don't want that to happen, especially to yourself, your staff members, and the patients around there. And that's the reason why it's critical, because you have to be able to do this as a psych nurse. And don't worry, guys, you are going to be trained. They're going to give you the tools that you need in order to provide this. So don't be scared of that action. Just don't be scared of that, because it's going to happen and you're going to be able to learn those methods to actually intervene. But it is a huge responsibility of a psych nurse to be able to intervene when possible. So the fourth critical responsibility of a psych nurse is you have to be able to be part of a treatment team. And the good thing about being a psych nurse is you're able to collaborate with so many team members in the hospital, especially in the hospital on inpatient units. You get to collaborate with other nurses. You get to collaborate with MAs. You get to collaborate with mental health workers. You get to collaborate with the social working team. You get to collaborate with psychiatrists. You get to collaborate with so many different people. And your input is extremely crucial, because you want to be able to have everyone understand what you see, because at the end of the day, the nurses are with them 24/7. Social workers aren't there all the time. Psychiatrists aren't there all the time. Psych nurse practitioners aren't there all the time. But the psych nurses are the ones that have the most communication with the patients, and they're able to assess the behaviors as much as possible. So you have to be part of this team, and it's a critical responsibility of yours to observe all of these things, because you're going to be relaying all their behaviors and all the messages that they have to the team, and you guys are crucial. So definitely take in this in consideration if you are going to be working as a psych nurse. So the fifth and final critical responsibility of a psych nurse is you have to maintain a healing and safe environment for all patients. And this is a critical one, because without you guys, you're not going to have the ability to create this environment for the patients to receive the highest quality of care. And it's important for you guys to understand that this is what psych nurses do. We have to keep ourselves safe, our patients safe, and pretty much everyone around us safe. And you want to be able to create an environment where the patients feel like they're safe from other patients, or safe in terms of healing, because at the end of the day, there's a reason why they're there. They want to get the help that they need, and you have to be able to create this healing environment for them to get the highest quality of care possible, for them to heal and get back to their normal lives. And this is an important one. Like I said, all of these reasons are important, and all of these responsibilities are important to understand, because at the end of the day, this is why we're there. Yes, we might not be doing as many things in terms of physical skills, or like skills like starting IVs, skills like inserting NG tubes, skills like blood draws, things like that. We might not be able to do all of those things. Yes, there's certain units where you can, but for the most part, we're providing a service where it's a lot larger than that. The cause is way better than what those little things might be doing. You're doing a lot more, especially in the long run, by being able to provide all of these responsibilities. So yeah, you guys have a huge responsibility. Psych nurses do so much on the unit, and I love every single one of the nurses that I work with, and I was one of them, and I absolutely loved what I did. So if you are even considering being a psych nurse, think about all of these responsibilities and think about how much of an impact you guys are going to make in the long run. It's amazing. Trust me, it's extremely amazing. Well, guys, I just wanted to make this video because I figured not a lot of people understand what responsibilities are there, especially as a psych nurse on an inpatient unit. This can apply for urgent cares also, depending on how they're actually laid out. But for the most part, psych nurses do a lot, and I applaud you guys all. So if you want to be a psych nurse, I definitely recommend even thinking about it, because it's amazing. You feel so much better at the end of the day in being able to provide all of these services. And I figured, why not show exactly what we do and the responsibilities we have in order for us to provide the highest quality of care possible for each and every individual patient we come across. Well, guys, as always, have a wonderful day. Until next time, bye.